What's good, Bucket Nation? It's your boy Pat Buckets here, about to bring you another video here on my channel. As today, I'm going to be bringing you a new album review here. As we're going to be reviewing DJ Khaled's new album. And if you guys may have seen, I posted another video like this beforehand, but the issue was that the whole video did not upload, only half of the video uploaded. I don't know what happened, but I have to redo this again. I have to do it on a phone so the screen can be a little smaller. Oh, the lighting's not great, but we're just gonna have to deal with it. It's been annoying to do this. I'm gonna have to figure out some stuff coming up. But other than that, guys, let's just get the album. I wanna get this done quickly because I already did this, now I have to go through it again. So, I'm gonna give you sneak peeks of the songs. I already listened to them. I'll just give you guys sneak peeks of the song. It won't be long. It'll be maybe like a minute or two. Maybe a minute of the song. So here we go. First song is called Holy Mountain. It's featured by Budge. Benton. So yeah, guys, I'm only gonna give you sneak peeks. I'm trying to get this done quickly. I already did this video, not do it again. But I didn't like. So this is a song I didn't get into really. Was not interested. Didn't really like. I didn't like the rhythm. I didn't like the beat. Yeah, it just wasn't for me. Maybe for some people, it was the number one song, shockingly, on the album. But even though it doesn't even have a hit, so I don't know why it was number one. But whatever. It's not. I just didn't like the song. So let's move on. Man, I wish it. Wish it didn't have to do this again, but whatever. Next one. This one's called Wish Wish with Cardi B and 21 Savage. So yeah, guys, this is number two, like I said, on the charts. It is a hit, and it's called Wish Wish. I did enjoy the song. I like both Cardi B and 21 Savage's parts. I'm not really that big of a fan of Cardi B, but I think she did a good job on this song, and 21 Savage is always pretty good with his music, too. I like the beat, I like the music, I like them together in this song. I think it was pretty fire, and yeah, definitely, I'll give that probably like a 7. So let's move on. I'm sorry, I'm gonna do this quickly. I'm gonna have to skip through the songs a little bit, so you're gonna hear the first part, a couple parts, and then I'm gonna skip it to a little other part because I'm just trying to get through this quickly, guys. I'm sorry. Jealous is the next one. Chris Brown and Lil Wayne said this, and I actually did enjoy the song.
Another one. You need somebody, baby. You need somebody, baby. I pick you up in my
My bad, guys. She posts a pic of me and her from up her iPad. You know the ones don't like that, where the likes at. Jealousy is a disease, you can die mad. Don't you Sean C B Cali high man? Way to let something die's lack of attention. And you got it all, you looking good as my attention. We on an ascension, straight up. Yeah, so, like I said, this is one of my favorite songs on the album, definitely. It was fire. I feel like Chris Brown was fire in the song. And so is Lil Wayne. I think they're both fire in the song. I really enjoyed this song a lot. It's definitely gets a 8 out of 10 from me. But we're gonna see a 9 and pretty much and a half from me coming up soon in the next couple songs. So here we go. Next song is called, Just Us. So I'm gonna quickly play that snippet of this song. So yeah, guys, this song is pretty good. I actually kind of enjoyed it. It definitely is not like top 5 material, but I did enjoy the song. I feel it was an entertaining song to listen to. I like the beat, I like the music. I'm gonna give it though like a 6 out of 10, about maybe a 5, but a 6 out of 10. Definitely not my top 5, but I kind of enjoyed the song though. So shout out to SZA. I still don't know who that is, but shout out to her. So next song is You Stay. This is, like I said, this song isn't in my top 5. I really like this song.
You do it, but you did it. tell you different. You know I never speak on that nigga. It's not my business. But I can tell you that his level's no competition in him. Optimistic in him. About to hit it in him. I can tell you been crying behind the civics because I caught you slipping, left you no choice. You ever cry again, it's gonna be in a world's race. I wipe your face with them new hunters to make your tears dry. Hitting it on a jet, this ain't no red eye. Got you chasing dreams that it ain't even bedtime. And don't you dare bring up your ass to see a dead guy. I wonder why, oh why, do you ride, do you stick by his side? If it makes you cry every night, girl, I see the pain in your eyes. I don't know why, oh why, you stay, you stay. I just wanna see you smile. I can tell you need somebody who really about you, who gon' see about you, cause it's been a while, so baby, why?
Yeah, so guys, this one's definitely, I'm gonna already tell you guys, this was my fifth choice. It was a tough choice between this one and another song that we'll be playing up later. I really enjoyed the song, Meek Mill's part was fire. I think the whole song was fire in general. Got a little bit to get into it, but other than that, when I got into it, I really got into it when I listened to it before. you guys gonna have to go with me with this throat, my throat scratching up or my voice losing. I just did this and again it didn't work, so you guys are gonna have to deal with it. But like I said, I'm gonna give this easily a 8 out of 10. So the song gets the cut in the top 5. And here we go. This song, I can listen to again, because this song is fire. Because the next song is called Celebrate with Travis Scott and Post Malone. And it, I can't wait to listen to this again. This song, I'm actually kind of pumped to listen to again. But here we go. Celebrate. This is my number one. I'm already telling you guys, this is my favorite song on the album. Here we go. Post Malone's fire. So like I said, guys, this is my number one choice. This will cut the list as the best song on the album. On my, really, for me, how I feel is the best song on the album. I just enjoyed it. It's fire. I feel like it's just one of those songs when you freaking need to a song to get you maybe pumped a little bit, or you're upset, you're trying to get something pumped. This is something to listen to. It just puts you in that point where you just wanna, you know, it just fire. I don't say it fires you up, but it's just an enjoyable song to listen to. I feel also like a party song. It really does sound like a party song. I really like this song. It's up my alley, and just it was fire. Post Malone's fire. It's great to hear him again, and Travis Scott also is always fire. So yep, that makes the cut as the number one song here. Next one is Higher. This song was good too.
Don't I know that brothers see me down, put my soul in the fire. back to back every year for like 10. Pregnant with my mom's, doctor told her it was slim. It's been wrong for 9 months, but gave birth in the end. Bonnie turned 60, he proud what we done. In one generation, he came from Africa young. Said he met my mom's at the Century Club. Los Angeles love, kinda like Hustle and Book. Bonnie turned 10, Cross turned 2. Starting to see this life shift from a bird's view. We the ones that made millions off the curve. Fool in this rap shit, 10, never made nerve moves. Two of them. Emptied out the clip, it was broad day. Fuck niggas always gotta learn the hard way. We gon' tape it off if we ball play. Put a half a moon crescent on your ball fade. Police hit the lights, that's a car chase. Looking back at my life, make my heart race. Dance with the devil and test all faith. Thinking chess moves, but it was God grace.
So yeah, I'm gonna end this here. I did enjoy the song too. I liked Nipsey's part in it. You know, I feel like this is like an inspirational song, type of song. You know, and I just like the chorus to it. I like the beat to it. I liked everything about it. We'll just make the top five, but I'm going to have to figure this out again. I don't remember my top five at this point, but like I said, I'll let you guys know at the end of the song. So right now, I did like this. I'm going to give it a 6 out. I'm going to give it probably a 6 out of 10, I'd say. So yeah, let's move on. Next song is Won't Take My Soul. So I guess I will play more of it, but you know, I'm trying to cut this video a little shorter. But yeah, I enjoyed the song a lot. I like the opener. I like how it turns into a rap, and the rap fits this song. It's weird because I'm not that big of, you know, into the hard rap, but just the way the two parts mixed, I felt was great. I feel like the chorus is great. The rap was great. You know, you can't ask for a better. I feel like they did a great job on the song. I like both parts of the song. I think the song fire. I really did enjoy this song, so I'm going to give this a 7 out of 10. On to the next one. Next one's called Weather the Storm, featuring Meek Mill. This was one of the songs I did not like. Could be down my list. I'm only gonna play a little bit of it. Made the first like few seconds with it.
Jersey, damn ammunition.
Yeah, so compared to the two, the other Meek Mill song, I did not enjoy this one as much. It just didn't stick with me. This song, this thing, stick with me. I don't think I didn't get into it at all. The second time listening, I still didn't get in, still can't get into it. And yeah, makes the bottom of my list. Probably give it a 3 out of 10. Damn. Lose my voice, but I'm giving it a 3 out of 10, so let's move on. Okay, next one is another song I didn't really get into, but I'm gonna make a reference here. Right when the song starts, I'm gonna tell you guys what it is. It's called Big Boy Talk, featuring Jeezy and Rick. Okay, if you can hear this here, I feel like this song could be an NBA 2K. I feel like it's an NBA 2K type of song. I feel like it's a song that would do. But I feel like it's a song that they would do, and yeah, that's how I feel. Yeah, so I'm just gonna skip here. Yeah, I feel like this was more of a hardcore rap. I'm not really into hardcore rap. This song didn't stick with me either. Like I said, could be NBA 2K song for sure, but yeah, it just didn't feel with me. The last two songs definitely did not feel with me. This one's gonna get a 2 out of 10. I didn't enjoy it. So that's how I feel. And by it being a number 10 song, it looks like some people agree with me. Let's move on to number 11, which is Freak and You, featuring Lil Wayne. So yeah, guys, I really enjoyed the song. I love Lil Wayne's part. I think his part was fire. The girl who was singing this was alright. I liked her at the beginning. I feel like having this song, when she went back to that, was kind of annoying. But other than that, guy, I did enjoy this song. I like Lil Wayne's part. I think he was fire. The beat worked. Everything worked. His music, his chorus is really great. And yeah, I'm gonna give this 7 out of 10 because of Lil Wayne. So keep going, Lil Wayne. On to the next one. Which is Top On. I know this song, Top Off. I already know this song. It's by Jay-Z and Future, and I don't know what the last one is. That should be. Let's go really quickly listen to this again, but I'm not gonna play the whole song, like I said. I already know this song.
I said it's about the Maybach. To the top of my
Alright, other than that part, great song, fire, definitely top 5. I love the song, I love who's in it, except for the last person, I don't know who, I think it's Beyonce, honestly. It's just Beast, it probably is Beyonce. But, other than that though, yeah, I enjoyed this song, definitely a 8 out of 10 for me. I think I forgot to rate the, the celebration song. That is a 9.5 for me. Actually, I think it's turned into a 10. That song's just fire. So yeah, that's number 10. So top off makes the cut. I think it's gonna be number 3 on the cut. So that we'll leave it there. Next one's No Brainer. If no one's listened to her No Brainer, I don't know where you've been. No Brainer. The No Brainer is by Khalid, by DJ Khaled and Justin Bieber. I'm not gonna play it because that song's been out for a year. If you guys want me to play it, I'll play it for a second. But I'm not playing the whole song. We all know this song. This makes my top 10 for sure, maybe number 2. This song's just fire. That makes my top 5, definitely 8 out of 10 for me. Song's fire, I really always like No Brainer since it came out. And yeah, makes my top 5 easily. So next one's Thank You. And these last two songs are going to be below, because I didn't like either of them. But I'm just going to play them because I have to. It's the album review. So you guys can hear it.
You know, I never really met nobody who was truly successful that wasn't thankful. For the good and the bad. It made me who I am.
DJ Khaled.
When it get this dark, you gotta feel your way out. They tried to bury me alive, I kill Bill my way out. Letting go of grudges that I used to feel a way about. Cause some emotions are too taxing to keep paying out. Life is what you make it, I know I make it for sure to make it some more. I know critics hate it galore, it doesn't faze me no more. I know some people's only taste of success is the bite that they take out of yours. My Gigi told me God laugh at you when you make plans. The type of wisdom that made us men. Plus trying to thank everybody who helped us along the way is like trying to name every single member of the Wu-Tang Clan. Yeah, I might skip one or two, but that doesn't mean they wasn't just as part of the plan. Some love goes without saying. Who would have thought that DJ that was on 6 to 10 right there on 92 and 0? Fast forward later, this nigga Khaled, my neighbor. The type of stories that you can't make up. The universe doesn't just work it out, man. It works in our favor. What's heaven on earth? Go champagne. Plus, I gotta thank my exes on some thank you next shit. And all the old times, they gave me new perspectives. Speaking of new, I'm about to ink a new deal. Dying life records.
Yeah, I said I didn't really enjoy this song, but I'm gonna say this. It's crazy when you listen to this song. Give me a sec, guys. It's crazy when you listen to this song. And it sounds like he's just talking. Like there's a beat to it. There's music to it. But when he sings, it doesn't sound like he's singing. It sounds like he's just talking. Like he's talking to somebody and saying all this stuff. It is cool to see that. And I feel like Big Sean does that a lot. Song where it sounds like he's just talking. It's not for me. I'm not really into Big Sean. So this song wasn't really that good for me. It was the second to last song on the album. So I guess it didn't fit a lot of people either. So they probably agree with me. I didn't really enjoy this one. This one's getting a 2 out of 10. Sorry, Big Sean, but just not for me. So then the last one. This one, I don't know what to say to this one. But it's called Holy Ground. The other one was called Holy Mouth. This was called Holy Ground. It's also by Buju Banton. Banton. I don't know why I said Bonin, but whatever. Enjoy. Yeah, guys, honestly, I just don't know what to say about the song. Like, it's weird, like, when I listen to it a second time, it's like, it almost feels like it has something, like, maybe I can enjoy it, but it may be a song I have to go back and listen to a few times. Right now, it just did not stick with me. I don't know if it's just the way the song is, like, goes or whatever it is, or how I feel about the person, being I don't know the person, I don't know all this stuff. I threw this joke in there before that there was a part of this song where it sounded like if anyone ever saw the movie Mr. Bean or the show Mr. Bean, and Mr. Bean Holiday, or I think it was Mr. Bean Holiday, where he and this little kid were trying to raise money. So Mr. Bean took a radio, put on a song, started dancing, and one of the songs had that weird, like, it almost sounded like this voice in the song, and half it through that music video here, it almost sounded like exactly what they were singing in that song. It's kind of cool to hear that, but I can't believe I made a Mr. Bean reference in 2019, but why not, I guess. But yeah, guys, I don't really have an option. I'm not even going to rate it because I really don't know what to think about this song. So, on that, guys, I can quickly give you my top 5 again. Just again. So, like I said, Celebrate number 1, definitely. I want to say No Brainer number 2. Number 3 would be Top Off. I think that song was fire. Number 4, then I'm going to say You Stay. And number 5, I think I'm going to give it to Won't Take My Soul. Top Off, because I know the song and I actually really enjoy it. Me and my cousin listen to it whenever I'm in his car, so it is fire. I don't think he thinks I like the song, but I have grown on it, so yeah. And then literally it's between Freaking You or Won't Take My Soul. I actually gotta put Freaking You in there. Lil Wayne's in there. I'm gonna put a Lil Wayne song in my top 5. Freaking You is gonna go into my top 5. Won't Take My Soul. It's tough. It's gonna be number 6. But it's like it's an honorable mention into the number 5 spot. So yeah, so Freaking You. So again, Celebrate, No Brainer, damn, I forgot the songs again. Top Off, Jealous. I forgot about Jealous too. Jealous is fire. So Jealous actually might make the top 5. That means one of them has to come off. And I'm gonna put You Stay at my number 5. So that's my top 5 list, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please go like, subscribe, turn on the post notifications for more videos to come. I hope to get some more album reviews done soon when new more artists come out. I hope I can get my cousin Mike to me and Mike are gonna do a sports talk video hopefully soon here. Do some album reviews with him. I hope to get him soon, as thanks to him, Michael Marchand, my cousin, that he told me about this Khalid album this morning, so I can do the video. So I did the video, and I really enjoyed his album. I think I'm gonna put it in number 3 right now of the albums of the year so far for me, being Juice WRLD, PNB Rock, and now it's DJ Khaled. DJ Khaled just make the top 5 of the albums so far, 2019. So congratulations to DJ Khaled for making my top 3. I enjoyed his album. The only difference is that he wasn't almost in any of the songs. I didn't really hear his voice on it when he said DJ Khaled at the beginning and all this stuff like that. So it's kind of weird that you feature guys, but the features are the only ones singing. Like, he should be in there. That's my opinion, that DJ Khaled should be in the video. Should be at least in some of the songs that he's singing. But that's my opinion. You guys all probably have a different opinion, but that's just my opinion. I can make an opinion here because it's album review, so I can make a few my own judgment. And I feel like DJ Khaled should have been singing some of these songs. Well, other than that, guys, I did enjoy this album. I hope the next one comes out soon so I can do another album review. I really love doing these album reviews. I need to do them earlier in the day, though. I need to stop doing them late at night, but it's the only time I really have my own time to do this, so. Yeah, guys, this has been Pat Buckets, and that was DJ Khaled's Father of Assad album review. Till next time, stay strong, stay committed, and never give up on your goals. Till next time, guys, Pat Buckets is signing out for tonight. See you guys later. Peace from the Buckets channel. Love you guys.